Hi, in this video I will create an ASP.NET MVC Core 2 application where we show an article or some products in a small web application. So we have here Visual Studio 2017. And now I start at that point and I create a new project, and inside the project we go to new project, Visual C Sharp Web, and inside web we have ASP.NET Core Web Application. We don't take the web application from web form. And there we go in a subfolder. Like here, my web demo, I take this folder and say that that's the place where my project goes to. And I say, okay, web product web. Okay, for example, like this. So, and I say, okay, now system comes up with the .NET Core application or dialog, and it's ASP.NET Core. You have to install it in the Visual Studio installer so that you have all those features. And we don't take an empty web API or web application. We take the web application model view controller. So this has the structure where we have a controller, models, and a view. And I show you how this works. And it's not a single page, that's what I want to say. We don't take enable Docker support at the point, so we don't have GitHub and all the point and all the stuff, and we don't need authentication at the beginning. We start simply by this one. And then we have our first application, and the system made this small structure there. We have controllers, models, and views. When I open that point, then we have started with the IIS, Internet Information Server Express, then we see that it's running. So it's the system gets up a small template with some stuff in there, and for debugging, system creates a local host, so it's not the internet, it's running on my local system, only on my PC. We have the local host double point, and there's a port number, so it runs there. And I have there in this small template some links here on this menu, and on the main page there's let's say here this block is called carousel, and some stuff there with some links. Now, what does this is the content of that point of that stuff, and we need now to do the following. Inside of a content control, inside of MVC model view controller, we always start the point that we, for example, create a new model and say we want some products. So I add here a new class. And I will say here it's a class, and I say in this class these are products which I want to show. Now we have models, products, and inside there I will say give me a property, and then the tab key, and then it creates a small structure or a small template where I may enter my stuff. So I say public int, this is my ID product, and I need prop a string, small one, string my title, and that's it. And maybe public string details content, text, for example, like this. Get set. So this is now a small product as a class. Say I saved this one, and we have this now in our model, in our application. Now when I want to show that point, I create a controller. So I go there and say add a new controller, and there we start with an empty controller, so we get it from the base, and we call it not default controller, we call it product controller, because our model is also called products, so we call it products controller with the S. This is always the same naming convention. So it's scaffolding a new file. Needs a lot of time. So now when we have the products, we have here now the products web. This is our application. And in controllers, we have now the product controller. And we start with show me the details, for example. My details of this controller, and I want to show now when we have a controller, the system comes into when we get an question for products and then details. It's always when we say I think you're a little bit confirmed when you say HTTP my web how is it? Yeah, so HTTP products com database com, and then /products/details, and then maybe the ID, for example 500, for example, like this. So we have here, this is details, and that's what we have there. So, and what we do now is we say we want to show the system comes in by a router. The router is here in the startup. There's a router here in ASP.NET Core 2 routes the default to the controller, and it has to be created new routes in there. So system always follows the way I'm asking. With this web address, I say, okay, give me my application products detail. So it follows the controller products controller details, and details is the first action. Now go on. Now we want to show a view. We have control model view, and inside this application, building, I'm connecting the my model in there, and then I give it, I show it in a view. So we say here, give me my model. So this is product web models. And then we say here, products. That's what we have there, products. Products, maybe it's not the best that I said. Products. So next time I would rename it with simply product, but we go on with this. Act product equals new products, and then we take the curly bracket and say my title equals, the title is product one, for example, like this. And then we want to show it in a view, and we say here, show me my actual product. So, but at the moment we don't have a view. So we're connecting our product and we want to show it in a view. And the view has to be here in views. We have to create a new folder. We say here a new folder, which is called products. And then we say create a new view. And this view is called details. It's under the products folder, products, details. And we say user layout page, that's under the views shared. We see that's the layout, and we'll show you what this is inside the layout. We want to show it. So what does this layout does? When we click on that point, everything stays the same, and we drop it inside of a master page. And now in the in our HTTP, in our output side, we see some HTML code, and then this one with the at sign is always server-side stuff. So we view data is title details, means that's what the system says at the header as a head information. And it says, okay, the layout where it is dropped in is the underscore layout CSHTML. Now when we want to show our products, this output page needs the models products web models, and then products. So, and now we want to show here in the header, this is my product, a headline. We say add model, and here show me the title. So what we do here is, first we say here with a small m, we say model, and we say embed the product which is behind that structure. And then show me that that model. And now we save that point, and I will say started. I'm not sure if I've taken everything. System will start. And now we are first in our default site. And when I go there and type in products, products details, then we will see our first product. That's nice. So what we see there now, I embedded that stuff. The product is now this frame. It's let's see if I may show you. This frame is our is the stuff from here where we say drop everything into the layout. And now when we open the layout, then we see that's the real HTML website. And inside the website, we have then here products web, footer, and that's because this is the content, body content, div container header. This is our, that's the head area. And now where's the big block? It will be dropped in somewhere in there. So I'm not sure at the moment where this dropped to, because we always need a container there, and inside the main container it's added, it's normally added on there. So now that's why we use the layout, and the layout is nothing else than it's in web form, it's called master page. What also my opinion, very good solution. So, and what we saw now in this example is the construction of controllers, models, and view. First, create a model, then create a controller with the name with the same name, and inside there we need an action. We need an action, which is called has a name where it's an entry point. Then we create here one of those models. In this case, it's a product, and then we give it out as a view. And the view by convention is always the same name which has this name. So that's by naming convention. So we have here in our views, products, details, that site.